Hello guys, welcome to today's class. In this class, we are going to discuss few more problems based on Jacobians. One of the problems already written on the board. The problem is if x equals r sine theta cos phi, and then y equals r sine theta sine phi, and z is equal to r cos theta. Find partial derivative of x, y, z is depending upon more than one independent variables are r theta phi. Therefore, partial derivative of x, y, z with respect to r theta phi. Actually, what they provide, x, y, z are nothing but, is nothing but spherical polar coordinates. These are the nothing but spherical polar coordinates. Now, what they given in the problem, first I told number of times, first you write it the Jacobian in terms of determinant, then easy to identify what are the partial derivatives are expecting with respect to what are the independent variables. Now, from the definition of Jacobian of x, y, z with respect to r theta phi can be written as dou x by dou r in the row wise, dou x by dou theta, and also I have to take dou x by dou phi. This is nothing but x with respect to r theta phi. Next, move to y. Y, partial derivative of y with respect to r, with respect to theta, with respect to phi. Okay. And also I have to take z with respect to r, with respect to theta, and then with respect to phi. Okay. Now this shows that if you want to find out these first order partial derivatives, we are expecting x, y, z are nothing but functions of r theta phi. Anyway, it's already given r theta phi. Therefore, better I have to take the given. What's a given actually? Given is nothing but x equals r sine theta cos phi. Okay. And then what is my y? Y is nothing but r sine theta sine phi. Okay. And then what is my z? Is nothing but r into cos theta. Okay. Now, this is a very simple function. No need I to find out partial derivative of x with respect to x, with respect to r theta phi. If you want to find out separately also, no issue. What is my dou x by dou r? With respect to r, r only vary. The remaining, independent variables are temporarily constant. Therefore, sine theta into cos phi is constant. What is the derivative of r with respect to r is 1. Similarly, what is my dou x by dou theta? With respect to theta, r and cos phi are constant. Then what is derivative of sin theta is cos theta. Okay. Now, derivative of this is cos theta. And next, what is my dou z by dou x by dou phi? Let me take with respect to phi. With respect to phi, r and theta is constant. Therefore, r into sin theta is constant. What is derivative of cos phi with respect to phi is minus sine phi. Okay. These are the nothing but what x with respect to r theta phi. Next, I move to y with respect to r. Y with respect to r is nothing but sine theta into sine phi into derivative of r with respect to r is what? 1. And also I have to find out partial derivative of y with respect to theta. With respect to theta, what are constant? R and phi are constant. R into sine phi is constant. Derivative of sine theta with respect to theta is cos theta. Similarly, dou y by dou phi is nothing but r into sine theta is constant. Derivative of sine phi with respect to phi is cos phi. Okay. I move to next is z. In the z, dou z by dou r, with respect to r, theta is constant, cos theta into derivative of r with respect to r is 1. Dou z by dou theta, with respect to theta, r is constant, derivative of cos theta is minus sin theta. Okay. Now, what is partial derivative of z with respect to phi is 0 because the z is not a function of phi. Both r and theta is constant. What is derivative of constant is 0. Okay. Keep in mind this is one of the important thing. Here r and theta is constant with respect to phi. It's not involving any phi. What is derivative of constant is 0. Now these are the value we are going to substitute where in the determinant. Therefore, in the next step, jacobian of x y z with respect to r theta phi is nothing but determinant of dou x by dou r is nothing but what actually sine theta into cos phi. And next is with respect to theta, now we get r cos theta cos phi. With respect to phi is minus r sine theta sine phi. Next move to with y, second row. Sin theta with dou y by dou r is sin theta into sin phi. Dou y by dou theta is r sin theta into sin r cos theta into sin phi. Okay. R cos theta into sin phi. Next is with respect to phi is r dou y by dou phi is r sin theta into cos phi. Next, dou z by dou r is cos theta. And next, dou z by dou theta is minus r into sin phi. Sin theta, not phi. Because z is r cos theta, what is dou z by dou theta is minus r sin theta. Derivative of cos theta is minus sin theta. This is 0. Okay. These are the values. Next, you know how to evaluate 3 cross 3 determinant. Plus, minus, plus. In the next step, yeah, the rest of the thing you know how to simplify 3 cross 3 determinant. Okay, fine. In the next step, this is nothing but sin theta into cos phi. This is cos phi of this into this. If you want, just I'm going to write in the first operation is this. This is plus, this is minus. Now what we get actually 0. Once you go for up arrow, minus, minus, you already have minus, minus into minus, plus, right? R into R is R square, sine theta into sine theta is sine square theta into cos phi. Okay? These are the values for what actually, this one, first term, then second term, minus R into cos theta cos phi. Of now I'm going to remove this operation. Okay, while this comes in first row second column, you neglect that. We are going to take operation this with this and also this with this. Okay, fine. From this, while taking the down arrow plus, taking up arrow is minus. Okay, now 0. Okay, again we get 0 minus, once you take up arrow, minus r sin theta cos theta r into sin theta into cos phi. Yeah, for time being, now we have to remove this operation. Okay, fine. Yeah. Okay, fine. First I have to write properly for this function sin phi sin this. Okay, fine. And next, this is actually what this one last term plus into minus is actually minus. We get minus sign. Okay, fine. Minus r sine theta sine phi. It's into, now what now at this element occurring first row, third column you neglect. Now we have to take operation between these two values plus. This become minus. Okay, fine. Of minus r sin square theta sin phi. Okay. Again up arrow minus r into what cos square theta sin phi. Yeah. This is a expansion of the accuracy determinant. Now I have to simplify. Now observe carefully, once you multiply this, what we get actually here, r square sine cube theta, yes, into cos square phi. Okay. And next, minus into minus plus r square sine theta, okay, and then cos square theta, cos theta into cos theta is cos square theta into cos square phi. Okay, fine. Okay, now from these two terms, you take common factor. What's a common factor? Minus r sine phi is common factor. Now you already have, please try to understand here, what's a common factor from these two terms? Minus r sine phi is common. Now you already have minus and outside minus into minus plus, already have r into r square. We are taking what's a common factor from these two terms. If for your reference, I'm going to write top of this. What is a common factor here? Minus r sine theta, we are taking common factor for this. Okay. Now, once you take this common factor, minus into minus plus, r sine r square, sine square, we are taking sine theta, we are taking sine phi. Yeah, observe carefully. What's a common factor? R sine, minus r sine phi is common. Minus into minus plus, now we get what we are going to take here, phi, sine phi, therefore this is sine theta only. Therefore, already one sine phi outside is there. Sine phi into sine phi is sine square phi. What's the remaining now? Remaining is sine square theta plus cos square theta. Observe carefully. Don't confuse. Now, what we are going to take common factor is minus r sine phi. Minus into minus plus r square sine theta. You already have sine phi. We get sine square phi. Now, what's the remaining? Sine square theta plus cos square theta. You already know that what is sine square theta plus cos square theta? The basic fundamental result is 1. Again, group first two, take common factor. What's a common factor from these two? The common factor is r square. Observe carefully what's a common factor. That's a very, very important. We are going to take sine theta, yeah, here having sine theta and also cos square phi. From these two terms, we are going to take r square sine theta and also cos square phi. Yeah, r square sine theta, because here even though I have sine cube, here what's the least power of sine is 1. Sine theta and cos square phi is common. What's the remaining? Here sine square theta plus cos square theta. What is sine square theta plus cos square theta is 1. R into sine theta into sine square phi. Okay. Now again this value is 1. Again you take a common factor from these two terms. What's the common factor? R square sine theta is common from both the terms. Therefore, what's the remaining? Cos square phi plus sine square phi. Again cos square plus sine square phi is 1. Now after, once you expand determinant using fundamental definition of determinant, don't leave it as itself. Try to simplify as possible. I have to simplify. Now finally we get what's the answer of this determinant value, r square sine theta. You can't simplify further, therefore we are going to leave it. This is the answer of the given Jacobian of xyz with respect to r theta phi. Keep in mind, first you express Jacobian in terms of determinant. After, once you express in the form of determinant, what are the first order partial derivatives are expecting in the determinant, first you find out. After, once you substitute the values, you expand the determinant using basic concept definition of determinant. After you expand, don't leave it as itself. As possible, I have to simplify with the help of the fundamental simplification. Once you simplify that, after that, then finally, this step, for example here, as possible I have to simplify, finally we get r square into sine theta. I can't simplify further, I'm going to leave it as itself. This is the solution of the given Jacobian of the problem. Okay, now I'm going to show zoom out entire problem in one screenshot. Observe carefully, this is a function they given, this is nothing but actually spherical polar coordinates. Now, they're given already x, y, z. See, keep in mind, whenever you want to find out Jacobian value, First, we express the Jacobian in terms of the determinant. Then immediately have to know that if you want to find out these partial derivatives, what type of functions are expecting. Here, once you express in the form of determinant, immediately it's clear x, y, z are functions of r theta phi. Now, anyway, is already given x, y, z are functions of r theta phi. Okay. Now, move to the next problem. Okay. Next problem, today's second problem. Yeah. If u equals x plus 3y square minus z cube and then v is 4x square yz, w is 4z square minus xy. Yeah, I'm going to repeat once again the function. If u is x plus 3y square minus z cube, v is 4x square yz, w is 2z square minus xy. Evaluate Jacobian of uvw with respect to xyz at, they given some particular point, at 1, 1, minus 1, 0 means x is equal to 1, y is equal to minus 1, z is equal to 0. Yeah. First, you have to express the given Jacobian in terms of determinant. Jacobian, partial derivative of uv, w with respect to x, y, z is nothing but Jacobian of x, y, uv, w with respect to x, y, z is nothing but first order partial derivative of u with respect to x, y, z. Yeah. Second row is first order partial derivative of v with respect to x, y, z. Third one, first order partial derivative of w with respect to x, y, z. Okay, fine. Now, if you want to find out these partial derivatives, you are expecting u, v, w are functions of x, y, z. The given already u, v, w are functions of x, y, z. What's given actually? U is equal to x plus 3y square minus z cube. Okay. And also the given v is nothing but 4x square y, z. And also w is nothing but 2z square minus x, y. The given u, v, w are functions of x, y, z. Now, I have to find out dou u by dou x. It's already given in the form of x, y, z. Directly, I have to find out dou u by dou x. What is dou u by dou x? With respect to x, temporarily, the remaining independent variables are constants. Therefore, y and z are constant. What is derivative of x with respect to x is 1. And then dou u by dou y. What is my dou u by dou y? Is with respect to y, x and z are constant. Therefore, 3 into what is derivative of y square with respect to y? 2y. We get 3 to the 6, 6y. What is dou u by dou z? What is dou u by dou z? Is with respect to z, x and y are constant, minus what is derivative of z cube with respect to z? 3 z square. Therefore, what do you, now we get dou u by dou z is minus 3 z square. Okay. I move to the next one, v with respect to x, y, z. Okay. Dou v by dou x with respect to x, y and z are constant, 4 y, z are constant. What is derivative of x square? 2x, 4, 2 is 8, 8 x, y, z. Okay. And also find out dou v by dou y. With respect to y, 4x square where z is constant. Derivative of y with respect to y is 1. Okay. Dou v by dou z with respect to z, y, x and y are constant. Derivative of z with respect to z is 1. Similarly, dou w by dou x with respect to x, z constant is equal to 0, minus y into derivative of x with respect to x is 1. And next, dou w by dou y with respect to y, again z and x is constant, we get minus x into derivative of y with respect to y is 1. Dou w by dou z with respect to z, z is very 4z minus 0. This is a way I find out the derivative of the function with respect to x, y, z. What we are going to do? First, we have to substitute these values in the Jacobian. Okay. Jacobian of u, v, w with respect to x, y, z is nothing but determinant of dou u by dou x 1, 6x, 6y and then minus 3z square. Dou v by dou x is 8xyz. Dou v by dou y is 4x square z. Dou v by dou z is 4x square y. Next, dou w by dou x is minus y. Dou w by dou y is minus x. And then dou w by dou z is 4z. Yeah. These are the values. But observe carefully here, I don't want Jacobian of u, v with respect to x, y, z. I want Jacobian of u, v, w with respect to x, y, z at which point 1, comma, minus 1, comma, 0. Before going to evaluate this determinant, first you have to substitute the values of x is equal to 1, y is equal to minus 1, z is equal to 0. We get very simple value. Then easy to evaluate the determinant. Suppose they want Jacobian of u, v, w with respect to x, y, z means to evaluate directly. But here I don't want the Jacobian value. I want Jacobian value at the particular point. Yeah, Jacobian of u, v, w with respect to x, y, z. We are going to take based on which function, which point at 1, minus 1, 0. Now we are going to substitute these values in the determinant. 1, minus 6, because y is minus 1. Z is 0, therefore this term must be 0. Okay, fine. Z is 0 means product must be 0. Z is 0, the product is 0. Product is 0. Next, x is equal to 1, yeah, 1 square is 1, y is minus 1, we get minus 4, okay. Y is equal to minus 1, already have minus, minus into minus, what we get actually 1. X is equal to 1, minus 1. And then z is equal to 0, this is 0. Then we are going to solve easily for this. Yeah, there are two ways. If we want to evaluate this determinant, next at the end put x is 1, y is minus 1, 0. That is very tedious. But they are not asking that value, no? They are asking at the particular value. What's the particular value? This 1, minus 1, 0. Better I have to substitute in the Jacobian before going to expand the Jacobian. Then easy to find out the value. Okay? Now, 1 into, you know that 0, yeah? Minus of, yeah, once you go for upper arrow, this minus, but minus into minus plus, we get 4, okay? The middle sign is minus, but already have 6 also minus, okay, better write minus 6, 0, okay? Upper arrow, minus of 1 into minus 4, we get minus 4. Whatever the last term must be, 0. Because this product, this value is 0, not necessary to find out the rest of the thing. And to simplify, minus 4, okay? Minus into minus plus, 6, 4 is 24. Minus 24 plus 24 is 20. This is a way, easiest way I have to find out the value of the corresponding Jacobian at the particular point. Now, before moving to the next problem, I want to discuss this because observe carefully one thing. Whenever you want to find out Jacobian value at a particular point, first you expand the Jacobian in terms of the determinant. What after that, what are the first order partial derivatives values are required? First you find out and substitute. Before going to expand the determinant, first you take at which particular value I want this Jacobian. At which particular value I want 1, minus 1, 0. Once you substitute these values in the determinant, we get very simple value. Then easy to expand the determinant. Please take care. Suppose they give this type of problem in the exam or maybe in the test. Now, this is the easiest way to solve the problem. Whenever I want to find out Jacobian value at the particular point, after expand in terms of the determinant, before going to expand the determinant, first you have to substitute that particular value for x, y, z. Then after that, you expand the Jacobian. Then once you expand the Jacobian, very easily we get the required value of the given Jacobian for the corresponding particular part. Okay. Now move to the next problem. Okay. Next problem. Move to next problem. The next problem is if u equals x into 1 minus y and v is xy, find the Jacobians J equals Jacobian of UV with respect to XY and J dash. What is my J dash? Jacobian of XY with respect to UV. First up, verify that J into J dash must be equal to 1. Our identity determinant are 1. Yeah. First you find out these two Jacobians. Jacobian J and J dash. Okay. Solution. J is what? Jacobian of UV with respect to XY. I told number of times. First you express Jacobian in terms of the determinant. U with respect to x and y, v with respect to x and y, v with respect to x and y. Okay, fine. Now, if you want to find out these values, I want what type of function? U and v are functions of x and y. They're given already. What's the given actually? Given u is x into 1 minus y. What is my v? Is nothing but x, y. First you find out dou u by dou x. What is dou u by dou, with respect to x, which is constant? Y is constant, therefore this factor is constant. 1 minus y is constant, derivative of x with respect to x is 1. What is dou u by dou y? Dou u by dou y, x is constant because it's a product. What is derivative of 1 is 0. Derivative of minus y with respect to y is minus. Now I have to find out the value of dou v by dou x. What is dou v by dou x with respect to x? Y is constant, y is 1. Y into x is 1. Dou v by dou y is what? X is constant. Derivative of y with respect to y is 1. Now these are the values we get. Now I have to substitute in the Jacobian. Okay, fine. J equals determinant of dou u by dou x, 1 minus y. Dou u by dou y is minus x. Dou v by dou x is y. And dou v by dou y is x. Yeah. Now, then easy to evaluate this. Just 2 cross 2 determinant, very easy. Then we have to take lower arrow and upper arrow. While taking upper arrow is minus, lower arrow is plus. X into 1 minus y minus into minus. You already have minus, upper arrow minus, minus into minus plus x. Now x into y. Okay. Yeah, minus into minus plus xy. You simplify that. X minus xy plus xy. What's the remaining? X is remaining. J value is x. Next, similarly, I have to find out the value of what actually j dash. What is j dash here? Yeah, j dash is nothing but Jacobian of xy with respect to u and v. Okay, fine. That is nothing but partial derivative of x with respect to u, with respect to v, partial derivative of y with respect to u and with respect to v. Observe carefully, if you want to find out these two values, first I have to express x and y in terms of x and y are functions of u and v, or first I have to express x and y in terms of u and v. But what is the given actually? The given is, what is u? The given u is x into 1 minus y. What is v? Xy. Now I have to express x and y are functions of u and v. How to express now? I have to simplify. U equals x minus xy. What is xy? Because I want to express u in terms, what about that, x and y in terms of u and v. What is x and y from the given v? Therefore, this implies u is what? X minus v. From that, we get automatically what is my x. What is my x? U plus v. We get x, u or x in terms of u and v. This is the way I have to find out. Okay. The next is, you have u, v is xy. We already know that x value. From that, we get y value. Therefore, this implies what is my y is v by x. What is x? U plus v. Now, automatically we get x, u, x and y are functions of u and v. Observe carefully. X and y are, we get the functions of u and v. Now, I have to find out what are the partial derivative. Do x by do u. With respect to u, which is constant? V is constant. And also, what is do x by do v? With respect to v, which one is constant? U is constant. Only v is varying. Okay, fine. Do x by do v. Okay. Now, I have to find out similarly for do, do y by do u. With respect to u, v is constant. Just like a derivative of 1 by x with respect to x. What is derivative of 1 by x with respect to x? Minus 1 by x square. Okay, fine. Now, we are going to take what actually? Minus 1 by x square. What is x? Just like a otherwise you take derivative of 1 by x plus 2. What is derivative of 1 by x plus 2 is minus 1 by x plus 2 whole square. Here 2 is v. Because v is constant, minus 1 by u plus v whole square. Okay, fine. Similarly, I have to find out dou y by dou v. But you can't do it like that because both numerator denominator having v, I go for quotient rule. U plus v whole square, denominator whole square, denominator into derivative of the numerator with respect to v1. Minus numerator into derivative of the denominator. U is 0, but v is 1. Now, I have to simplify this. U plus v minus v is cancelled. What's remaining is u divided by u plus v whole square. Now, this is very simple. U plus v minus v. Minus v plus v is cancelled. What's remaining? U by u plus v whole square. Okay. Next, we have to substitute these values where in j dash. J dash is nothing but determinant of dou x by dou u is 1. Dou x by dou v is 1. Dou y by dou u is nothing but minus v by u plus v whole square. Okay. This is nothing but dou y by dou v is nothing but u divided by u plus v whole square. Now, when to you said 2 cross 2 determinant, just you multiply that u divided by u plus v whole square. Once you go for upper arrow, minus, but you have one of the function is minus, we get minus into minus plus v divided by u plus v whole square. Now, the common thing is u plus v whole square. What's the remaining in the numerator? U plus v. What's the remaining? 1 by u plus v. Okay. Yeah. Now we are going to express C. Jacobian of xy with respect to uv is what actually? 1 by u plus v. But already find out Jacobian j value in terms of x and y. Once you get the value of j dash, after that, I'm trying to express this also in terms of x and y. Otherwise, leave it as itself. And then, at verify j into j dash. Therefore, consider, to verify that j into j dash is 1 or not. Yeah, j into j dash. Yeah, what is my j value? X. What is j dash? 1 by u plus v. Now, I try to express u and v also in terms of x and y from the this one. You know that already. What is my x after the simplification? X is nothing but u plus v. Therefore, we get 1 by x. It's cancelled, we get 1. Therefore, it's verified j into j dash. This way, sometimes verify, sometimes they're going to give through that. Now, before moving to the next problem, I'm recall once again all the steps. Okay. Now observe carefully, the given function is, now it's not possible I have to show it entire problem in one screenshot because it's a little bit lengthy problem. Okay, fine. Yeah. Now first I'm going to show it j value. Okay. Yeah. What is my j value? See here, first you find out j and j dash and verify j into j dash. First you express j in terms of determinant, Jacobian in terms of the determinant. Once you express that, we get a first order derivative of u and v with respect to x and y. If you want to find out these things, first you have to express u and v are functions of x and y. It's already given. Then easily I have to find out the value, substitute and simplify, we get j value. Similarly, I want to find out j dash. While finding j dash value, observe carefully, we have to take care with the thing for this. While finding j dash. While finding j dash is nothing but first you express in terms of the determinant. I told number of times whenever I want to find a Jacobian, first you express in the form of determinant. After that, I have to decide what type of functions are required based on the partial derivatives involved in the determinant. Once you express that, we get dou x by dou u, dou x by dou v, and dou y by dou u, dou y by dou v. If you want to find out these first order partial derivatives, first you have to express x and y in terms of u and v. Now, once you express that, now first you take the given function, try to express x and y in terms of u and v. Therefore, what I did here, I taken v is nothing but xy, substitute, we get x value. Once you get x value, automatically we get y value. And then you find out carefully with respect to x, with respect to u and v, and with respect to what actually? X and y with respect to u and v. I think it's clear for this part. And then once you find out j value, j and j dash value, they're asking to verify whether it is equal to 1. Yeah. After substitute that, first value x, then try to express either x in terms of u and v or u and v in terms of x. Then you know that u plus v x is cancelled, we get 1. This is the way I have to do it. Okay. Now I move to the last problem for the Jacobian. I'm covering all the types of problem. Please try to understand that. Okay. It's not possible I have to show this problem, entire problem, one screenshot. Therefore, if you want, I'll show it once again for half of a problem on the screen. Okay. Yeah, this is the first part. And then this is the second part. Okay, last problem. Yeah. See, it's not possible. All the problem I will discuss in my video. Please refer any textbook and then you solve more problems. Especially for engineering, Higher Engineering Mathematics by Grewal textbook is your prescribed book. Please go through the textbook. That volume of the edition of the textbook is 43rd. Okay. The next problem is the fourth problem. If U equals x square minus y square, V equals 2xy, and x is equal to r cos theta, y is equal to r sin theta, find dou of uv, means Jacobian of uv with respect to r and theta. Jacobian of uv with respect to r and theta, want to find out. Okay, solution. Jacobian of uv with respect to r and theta. See, suppose you expand. Here I am not going to expand that. Suppose you expand that, what we get actually? Dou u by dou r, dou u by dou theta, dou v by dou r, dou v by dou theta. If you want to find out these values, u and v are functions of r and theta. It's not given u and v are functions of r and theta. It's not possible to convert directly, easily. It's possible, but it's not possible. It's not possible to convert easily. U and v are functions of r and theta, because they given u and v are functions of x and y, where x and y are functions of r and theta. Suppose express x and y in terms of r and theta, we get u and v are r and theta. It's not easy. It's very tedious. Now, it's given u and v are functions of more than one variables. Again, these variables are depending upon more than one independent variables. Now, why don't you go for chain rule for the Jacobian? Now, from the chain rule concept for Jacobian is, u and v are functions of x and y, where x and y are functions of r and theta. Therefore, what are the independent variables? R and theta. From the definition of composite function, what's the chain rule for the Jacobian is, Jacobian of uv with respect to x and y into Jacobian of x and y with respect to r and theta. This is the easiest way I have to find out. So whenever the given function is in the form of composite function, please try to understand composite function. In such cases, how to find out the Jacobian? Using one of the property, then easy to find out. This property is where go for, in which case, suppose the given function must be composite function. Is a composite function example, what they given function, okay? First you find out dou u, first Jacobian, find out the second Jacobian. Jacobian of uv with respect to x and y. From the definition of Jacobian, this can be written as partial derivative of u with respect to x and y, and also partial derivative of v with respect to x and y. Okay. No need I to find out separately, because this is a very simple. We already given u and v are functions of x and y. With respect to x, 2x, y is constant. With respect to y, x is constant minus 2y. Okay. Yes. And next, with respect to v, with respect to x. With respect to x, 2y is constant into 1. With respect to y, 2x is constant. Derivative of y with respect to y is 1. Now, let us simplify that. What we get actually, then the simplification is explained already so many times, plus minus, okay, fine. 4x square minus into minus plus 4y square. What's the common factor? 4 into x square plus y square. Fine. Similarly, I have to find out Jacobian of xy with respect to r and theta. Again, from the definition of Jacobian, this can be written as partial derivative of x with respect to r, with respect to theta, partial derivative of y with respect to r, with respect to theta. Partial derivative of x with respect to r, they're given already x and y function of r and theta, cos theta into 1. R into what is partial derivative of partial derivative of x with respect to theta, r is constant, derivative of cos theta is minus sine theta. And then, what is actually this value is nothing but dou y by dou r is sine theta. R into what is derivative of sine theta is cos theta. Simplify that, cos square, r into cos square theta, observe carefully, we have to write it properly for this. R into cos square theta. Once you go upper arrow, minus minus of minus plus r sin square theta. Take r is common. What is r? R is nothing but cos square theta plus sin square theta. What we get actually? R. Okay? Then, I have to substitute these two values in the required Jacobian of UV with respect to r and theta is nothing but Jacobian of UV with respect to x and y. What is that? 4 into x square plus y square into Jacobian of xy with respect to r and theta is r. But keep in mind, we are finding Jacobian, finding partial derivative of uv with respect to r and theta. We are expecting final solution either in terms of r, in terms of theta, maybe a constant. But is involving other than r and theta constant is x and y. I try to express this x and y in terms of r and theta. Now you know that what's given, x is equal to r cos theta and y is equal to r sin theta. What is my x square? X square is r square cos square theta. What is y square? R square. R square sin theta. Sin square theta. Because the given function is r sin theta. What is square of that? R square sin square theta. Okay? That implies what is my x square plus y square? R square cos square theta plus r square sin square theta. Take r square is common, cos square theta plus sin square theta. You already know that cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1, we get r square. Finally, we get this is nothing but 4r cube. This is the answer. This way I have to find out easily the solution of the given Jacobian. Suppose the given function is a composite function. Whenever the given function is a composite function, in such cases, better to use the chain rule formula for Jacobian. With the help of that, you try to find out the solution easily. Okay? I think it's clear everyone for this part. This properties we already discussed in beginning class of the Jacobian. Now, before I'm going to wind up the class, whenever the given function is in the form of composite functions, in that case, use the chain rule Jacobian formula. And that's why we beginning after the definition of Jacobian, we consider these two properties. Because now here, easily I have to find out. Without express x, u and v in terms of r and theta, then I have to find, using this property, easily I have to find out. Once we get this value, don't leave it. Because we are finding a Jacobian of uv with respect to r and theta means we are expecting a solution in terms of r, theta or constant. Other than that, you simplify that, what they given based on that. Once you simplify that, we get in terms of r. Finally, we get the solution is 4r cube. Okay. Now I'm going to wind up Jacobian. In the next class, we are going to discuss maxima minima for function of two variables. Until you take care, bye, see you.